Blackstone Audiobooks presents The Long March, How the Cultural Revolution of the 1960s Changed America by Roger Kimball. This book contains the following dedication. To Hilton Kramer. Introduction. What is a cultural revolution? Was the phenomenon, in fact, so extraordinary as contemporaries supposed? Was it as unprecedented, as profoundly subversive and world-changing as they thought? What was its true significance, its real nature, and what were the permanent effects of this strange and terrifying revolution? What exactly did it destroy, and what did it create? Alexis de Tocqueville, The Old Regime and the Revolution, 1856. The effect of liberty to individuals is that they may do what they please. We ought to see what it will please them to do before we risk congratulations, which may be soon turned into complaints. Edmund Burke, Reflections on the Revolution in France, 1790. Afloat but rudderless. In May 1994, the New York Times reported in its science pages on the unhappy fate of one Phineas P. Gage, a foreman for the New England Railroad. In 1848, Gage was helping to lay track across Vermont. His job involved drilling holes in large rocks, into which he would pour blasting powder and lay down a fuse. He would then cover the explosives with sand, tamping it all down with a long metal rod. One day, he inadvertently triggered an explosion. The metal rod went hurtling through his skull, entering just under his left eye, and landing some yards away. Amazingly, Gage survived the assault. He was stunned but able to walk away. And although he lost an eye, he seemed otherwise to recover. It soon became clear, however, that Gage was a sharply diminished man. His intellectual powers were apparently unimpaired. But what the writer for the Times called his moral center had been destroyed. Before the accident, Gage had been an intelligent, socially responsible, hard-working fellow. But in the weeks after the tamping rod pierced his brain, he began using profane language, lied to his friends, and could not be trusted to honor his commitments. Phineas Gage had become a moral cripple, utterly unable to make ethical decisions. Pondering the state of contemporary American cultural life, I have often recalled the sad story of Phineas Gage. Like him, our culture seems to have suffered some ghastly accident that has left it afloat but rudderless, physically intact, its moral center a shambles. The cause of this disaster was not an explosion of gunpowder, but a more protracted and spiritually convulsive detonation. One that trembled with gathering force through North America and Western Europe from the mid-1950s through the early 1970s and tore apart, perhaps irrevocably, the moral and intellectual fabric of our society. Even now, at the dawn of a new millennium, we are far from done tabulating its effects. The Long March, How the Cultural Revolution of the 1960s Changed America, contributes to that task. It is part cultural history, part spiritual damage report. It looks behind the received wisdom about the 60s to the animating ideas, passions, and personalities that made that long decade a synonym for excess and moral breakdown. Above all, the Long March aims to show how the paroxysms of the 1960s continue to reverberate throughout our culture. The age of Aquarius did not end when the last electric guitar was unplugged at Woodstock. It lives on in our values and habits, in our tastes, pleasures, and aspirations. It lives on especially in our educational and cultural institutions, and in the degraded pop culture that permeates our lives like a corrosive fog. Looking afresh at the architects of America's cultural revolution, The Long March provides a series of cautionary tales, an annotated guidebook of wrong turns, dead ends, and unacknowledged spiritual hazards. What is most obvious is often the easiest to overlook. To a casual observer, Phineas Gage might have appeared almost normal. So it is with our culture. Such blindness is a common byproduct of cultural and moral upheaval. In his book on the Ancien Régime and the French Revolution, 1856, Alexis de Tocqueville wrote that great revolutions which succeed make the causes which produce them disappear, and thus become incomprehensible because of their own success. Acceptance breeds invisibility.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.